Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 in Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_014_DIAB where you save it. Or you can download this file from the website. If you don't have this file, you can just sit down and watch. Now go to the Annotate tab and Dimension panel. Click the linear dimension and at the prompt specifying first extension line origin, start a dimension from this line. Then at the prompt specifying the second dimension line origin, click on this line. Move the mouse cursor out of the way and place the dimension approximately here. Next, we're going to use the continuous dimension line. What the continuous dimension line does is that it starts a dimension line from the previous object that you draw if you just use the linear dimension line. But if you have used any other command before you use this command, AutoCAD prompts you to select a dimension. Now, I'm going to select the linear dimension. As you can see, AutoCAD automatically remember the last dimension that I just drew. So if I want to select any other dimension, all I need to do, I'm going to select the select option on the status bar or type S on the keyboard and press enter. Now I want to continue with this dimension, so there is no need for me to select any other option. Go and click this option, then AutoCAD prompts you again to select another one. Continue to click until you finish what you want to dimension. When you specify the last extension line, press enter on your keyboard to end the dimension command. AutoCAD draw the dimension for you nicely. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, dimension panel, and select the linear dimension. At the prompt specify first extension line origin or select object. Zoom in into this area and click. At the prompt specify second extension line. Zoom in into this area and click. Move up and place the dimension approximately in this area. Now go to the home tab, dimension panel, and click the down arrow. Select baseline dimension. Now select this endpoint and this endpoint and this endpoint. Press enter to end the dimension command. This is how the baseline dimension work. Go to the dimension panel and select the linear dimension command again. This time we're going to use the object option. Press enter, then select this object. AutoCAD automatically place our dimension into this area. Again, the dimension interfere with the text, so I'm going to avoid this problem, I'm going to give a max to the text. Go to the dimension panel and click the dialog box launcher, click modify, and go to the text tab. In the fill color, click the down arrow and select background. This way AutoCAD use the background of the drawing as a max. That way any object that's below the dimension and not obscure the dimension text. Click OK and click OK to get out of the command. As you can see, now I can see the text, but the text still cover the, I can see the dimension text, but the dimension text still cover the other text, which is the dining. So I'm going to select it and go to the home tab, modify panel, and use the command to move it out of the way. Go to the annotative tab, dimension panel, and select the linear dimension command again. Now start the dimension from this point and this point. Click. Select the linear dimension command again. Start a dimension from this point to this point and move it approximately into this area. Select the continuous dimension and continue to dimension the object. press enter to end the command.